Live. Okay, we got Physical Science Atomic Structure Note Guide. Second or third page in the packet. Thumb through and find it. And we're just going to go by columns. So you need to know where protons, neutrons, and electrons are at. Okay? So protons are in the nucleus with the neutrons. Electrons are way, 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 way outside. And we'll show a video or bring that to life later as far as scale. But it's a pretty impressive scale. Size. Protons and neutrons are basically the same size. This one AMU means one atomic mass unit. Okay? And so neutrons are basically one atomic mass unit as well. Electrons don't even register as far as mass. When you weigh yourself on a scale, it'd be like adding an extra piece of hair in your head. It wouldn't even register. They're very, very, very tiny. But they do have a significant charge. Okay? So electrons are negative and equal but opposite charge to protons, which are positive. Neutrons, of course, are neutral. But neutrons are very important, and the role we're going to discuss. If you have a bunch of positive charges in the nucleus, there's no way that they should stay there all compact together. And that's the role of neutrons. Neutrons stabilize the nucleus with the nuclear force. And so yes, when you split the atom, you're releasing that nuclear force and you get big bangs for sure. Okay? The electrons, basically their role is involved in day-to-day chemical reactions. I put dynamite because that's like big bang stuff. When you watch Mythbusters and they blow up Buster a bunch of times, that's electron kind of chemistry. But just remember, it's also real subtle chemistry. Right now, if you guys had breakfast, your bodies have a chemical reaction going on, breaking down your food, heating up your body, producing energy, and it's still safe. You're not exploding. It's not explosive chemistry. So 99% of this class, we deal with electrons, either being given, taken, or shared. Okay, and that's the big story of this class. Okay, that's it. Okay, a few more details about the structure of the atom and relating it to the periodic table. In terms of atomic number, we're going to relate that to protons, atomic mass, and that's going to end up helping us figure out the number of neutrons. So this is addition math. So let's start with this. Protons, by definition, protons equals the atomic number. Okay, so on the periodic table for molybdenum, 42 means I have 42 protons. Okay, this is even easier math. Because it's neutral, by definition, protons equal electrons. And that means it's neutral. Later on, we're going to have ions, and that won't be the case. But for right now, electrons of a neutral element equals the electrons equal protons. Okay? The mass. The neutrons, it can be found by taking the mass minus protons. Okay? And so I'm going to write on the board here. A lot of times you'll see this symbol, and when you take notes on the book, they'll do this. And so one symbol, one molybdenum might be 95. The atomic mass would be 95. And the atomic number goes right here. And so what's great about this is that you can just simply subtract 95 minus 42. Okay, so that's a 3, and that's a 5. And this equals neutrons. So please go ahead and write that in. Okay? If you're trying to find protons, it's the mass minus neutrons. Same math. And if you're trying to find the mass, you add the protons with neutrons. So probably the base definition is mass equals protons plus neutrons. So, on your atomic mass worksheet number 1, the next page back behind this note guide, you guys are going to fill this in. And that'll be a different mini lecture.